us in our social networks, and you will see what we do. We have a Balsays Group channel in YouTube. It's a channel where we post the webinars, and we also do videos about immigration. So it would be good as well if you visit the YouTube channel and subscribe to it, because you will be updated about the videos that we do, the subjects, etc. We also have a website, balsaysgroup.com. Inside the website, there is a blog, and in this blog, we touch a lot of subjects of immigration. Every week, we post something interesting. You can follow up as well, and you can follow us and subscribe to our blog. And we have also a platform, a digital platform. It's called immigrationspain.es. And in this platform, we also speak about immigration. So Balsays Group website is more general about expats' legal advice in general, and Immigration Spain is more focused in immigration issues. And we have there as well a blog where we publish articles every week. So you can follow up, and also we are in Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and every day we publish something, a tip or something about our office, about our lawyers. Our idea is to be the house of all the expats. We are a family, and we want to increase the family with all of you in order to get the international community properly advised. Today, we are going to do this webinar from Barcelona. It's a very sunny day. It's starting the spring, the primavera. In some weeks, they will open the border, so we expect a lot of visitors. Besides, well, we will see what the COVID restrictions are on traveling, and probably in the future we will do a webinar about this issue as well. But it looks like that everything is getting better in regards to COVID with the vaccine. So let's keep positive, let's keep sunny like Barcelona, and let's hope we can see you not through the computer, in person in the office very soon. As an introduction, let me tell you, we are a law firm. We have lawyers and economists in our office, and we mainly do immigration, taxes, and accounting. We have a department who handles the taxes and the accounting of the companies and the private individuals. We do business legal advice as well. We corporate constitution of the companies, legal services such as court presence, and we also help on the real estate. What we help in the real estate, if you want to buy a property, we do all the legalities in order to protect you, and we follow up with the contracts, due diligence, notary, taxes, registration, etc. This would be in general the services that we do to let you know. And now, on regards to immigration procedures in Spain, we will give you some tips of all the process that we consider interesting for you. The first one we are going to touch is Golden Visa. Golden Visa is what it means, the investor residency permit. It's a residency permit that it was approved through the Law 14/2013. With the idea to attract investors in our country, especially on the real estate, because at that time we had a big crisis, a bubble on real estate, so the country needed to sell a product. So that's why they approved this law, in order to attract talent and investors and innovative projects. It was these the three areas. Now we are going to talk about the investors. And since then, since it was around 7 years ago, because we saw a lot of success on this law, a lot of people applied for this investor's visa, and we hope that after COVID, we will again be on the same successful procedure, no, for the people and with the investor, because now with COVID, a lot of people stopped the idea of investing on real estate in Spain. Now we expect it's going to be again reactive, and the prices actually they went down, so it's quite interesting on this sense as an investment, and we hope, we expect a lot of application again. On regards to Golden Visa, what you need to know, it needs to be done an investment. It has to be half a million, 500,000 euros in real estate, or 1 million in a bank deposit, shares of a company, or shares of a Spanish company, or 2 million in bonds of the state of Spain. The first residency permit is for 2 years, and the renewal for 5 years. You don't need to live in the country. You can live in your own country, but you will have an ID from a European country, which is Spain, that will allow you to travel in and out without a visa. And you will be able to renew it, besides you don't live in Spain, if you keep the investment. This would be the golden visa. Some general requirements is not to be European, of course, to be older than 18, not to have any criminal records on your country, to have a health insurance, and to show that you invested in a property in Spain without a mortgage. Another option for immigration to Spain would be the non-lucrative residency permit. This is getting very popular now. A lot of people apply to it because they are not sure about the investment, so they want to come to Spain with another type of permit, and then we'll see. The non-lucrative residency permit, most important is, well, you need to have a motivation letter where you explain the reasons, where you certify that you are not going to work in Spain. You don't need to have a criminal records. You need to contract a Spanish private insurance, health insurance, which is around 80 euros per month per person, the rate more or less. You need to prove 26,000 euros in savings plus 7,000 per each additional person of your family. And you need to prove it in which way? On the bank statement of the last 6 months. So on the last 6 months, you need to prove these savings. Plus, if you have regular incomes, such dividends, rentals, whatever, you can also include in this financial resources proof. And you need to have an address, or you need to explain on the motivation letter where you are going to live in Spain. As I said, this is general today. Then later on, you can ask questions, 10 questions we will answer. And if not, you send us an email. This is just an introduction to motivate you to come to Spain, which, as you can see, it's a fantastic country with very sunny weather, especially today in Barcelona. We are around 26 degrees. Student visa. Well, actually, another thing that I want to mention about the non-lucrative and the golden visa is that the golden visa you can apply from here. If you come here to Spain with all the paperwork and you do the investment, we can ask for the permit. The non-lucrative, the first permit you need to apply on the consulate of the country where you live. For example, in the UK, there is three consulates: in Edinburgh, in London, and in Manchester. So we need to see the jurisdiction, and you need to apply for this visa. And then the renewals, you can do it in Spain. On regards to student visa, there is two scenarios. The first scenario is that I come to Spain with all the papers and I enroll at university. During the 60 days, I enter into Spain and then I apply for the permit. So you can apply for the student visa inside the Spain. Second scenario is that I go to the consulate and I apply through the consulate for this student visa. This would be second scenario. What they require? Not to be European, to have economical means, it's around 6,500 euros to have private insurance, licensed in Spain, 80 euros approximately, and to be admitted in a course or university of more than 20 hours per week. It's very important this, because if it's less, they don't see it enough to give an authorization to study in our country, in Spain. Additionally to what I said, you need to also bring the criminal records. Let's go to the next one. The family reunification visa, it's a residency permit that is for those family. For example, I come to live into Spain as a resident, and after 1 year, I want to bring my wife or my kids. In this case, I need to prove the family relation, and I need to prove that the economical dependence for the last 12 months, in case I want to bring my parents, or the relation if I want to bring my kids or my wife or husband. This needs to be done at the immigration office in Barcelona. If they approve, then we can do the reunification. This would be more or less the idea of what is the family reunification. As always, not to be European, to have a residence permit for more than 1 year, to have enough money to bring them. There is a table of the resources that you need to have an adequate accommodation, a flat was enough big to live all the people. This is proved by an architect from the City Hall. The demonstration of the relation, the family relation, birth certificate, marriage certificate, and to have a private insurance as well, a health insurance. Residence permit as a family member of a European citizen. This is what a lot of people is doing now. The legal partnership, pareja de hecho. So if your partner, if your wife, if your husband is European and it's a resident of our country, of Spain, then you can apply for this type of residency permit. Also, if you have kids dependent on you and you are married with a European, you can also regulate them through this procedure. You have to be all of you above 18. In the case of pareja, de hecho, you need to be registered on the same address. You need to prove the relation and to have sufficient funds. Later on, if you want, we can discuss this process. We have a lot of several videos, not a lot, but 3 or 4 videos explaining very into detail this, so you can also visit us to double check as well. Interpreting your visa. This interpreting your visa, it is a procedure that is under the same law than the golden visa, the investor's visa, because the law, what it wanted is to regulate 4 things: investment, business entrepreneur, to regulate also talent workers, and to regulate also investigadores, university. So as entrepreneur, it's a residency permit that allows you to develop your business in Spain, but it needs to be a highly technological business, interesting for Spain and with value for our country. This would be the main idea of the entrepreneur visa. Work permit as a self-employed freelancer. This type of permit, you can apply through the consulate, for example, if you want to open a restaurant in Spain or you want to do a normal business. So entrepreneur visa, you can do it in Spain, but it has to be an innovative project. Self-employment, it must be done through the consulate. And it can be a normal business, but it has to be clear that it will be a legitimate business. And then, well, once if you come here as a student, after 3 years, if you get a work offer, you can modify your permit from a student to work. And if not, if you are studying in a place in a master that it's under a list of masters official, after 1 year you could change the student for searching for a job visa, and then if you find a job you can change. So if the master is not in this list, after 3 years, you can modify. If it's in this list, after 1 year, you can do the searching for a job visa, and then once you find a job, to modify. There is another exception if you find a highly qualified professional job offer. From non-profit visa to work permit, it would be the same as we mentioned before. Well, in this case, after 1 year of non-lucrative residency permit, you could modify if you open your own business or if you find a job offer. But it has to be after 1 year. And arraigo, basically, there is 3 types of arraigo. Arraigo, what it means, I come to Spain, I become irregular and illegal because I don't have a residency permit. After a certain time, I can regularize my situation to become a resident. Arraigo social would be after 3 years of being in our country, registered at the city hall, not more than 6 months out of the country, I could do this. Family arraigo would be in case my kids are here. And labor arraigo would be if I've been working illegally in a company and I can prove it and I go through the court and they give me the reason. This would be in general. Is everybody listening to me? Because I see that some people say that they don't listen. Yes, okay. There was a guy that said that he cannot listen to us. There is always somebody in the chat that says that he cannot listen. I don't know why. Okay, well, this would be all. As I said, it was a general trip into the permits, and then I'm ready to answer the questions. I'll go through the first one. Hello, if you are a British citizen and do not want to get a residence permit, what are the options to stay longer in Europe? Is there is a type of... No. Amanda, if you want, as a UK citizen, you are from a third state. It's called Tercer Estado. You are not from the European Union. So if you want, or you have the right with your passport to be here as a tourist, for a period of 90 days every 6 months. So every 6 months you can be in Schengen area 90 days, then you have to be 90 days out. This would be in general the rule. Other than that, you need to apply for a residence permit. Hi, second question. I have been in Spain for 2 years, continue, so I get my reason. What is the simple way? Also, I have work contract. Advise me. Thank you. Well, Chamin, that is, I would like you to send us an email to see if you have a permit or not. It's not clear for me. Rad, third question. Hi, I'm a Canadian citizen and I'm interested to know how to get a European citizen through Spain and working in Spain, IT industry as a freelance consultant. Well, first of all, as a Canadian, if you don't have any other that a Canadian, if you come to Spain and you get a residence permit, after 10 years you can get the nationality, or you can apply for it and then it takes another 2, 3 years, but you will need to reject the Canadian one. If you marry with a Spanish person, after 1 year of residency, you could apply for the nationality, and this would be the two scenarios. Question four. What is the investment amount required for gold? And if I want to leave Spain, can I sell my property? Well, on question number four, you need to invest half a million, 500,000 euros. And if you sell the property, then you lose the card, basically. So the card or the residency card is attached to the investment. Okay. Question number five. I have a TIE and I'm in Barcelona area. I had 1 year residence permit, then I rented for 2 years during pandemic. Now want an investor's golden visa as we have the investment. How difficult is to change negative to? Gary, the process is simple and it's fast also. So if you have the residency permit valid, we can request for the golden visa. We just need to prove the investment through the title, the escritura, the deed. And we need also to request the certificates of ownership. It's a procedure what we do at the property register, but it's also simple. Question number six. Bola Okanlowon. Hello. Hi, I come to Spain through student visa in 2019, but had issues with this renewal during the pandemic and hence lost my legality. Can I still apply for arraigo? Yes, we will need to study more in detail your case, but if you have been 3 years registered at the City Hall, not more than 6 months out of the country during this 6 months, you could apply for the arrival. Nabil Ali, hola. How can I get European residence while I have 5 years student stancy, and how many years is the European residency? Well, this we will need to study this situation. Well, we don't have Sandra. Question six. Do you have an office in Cartagena? No, but we work for a lot of people there and in other places of Spain online, because now, since COVID, all the immigration is done through the computer, so we can deal with anything in your area besides we don't have an office. Bob Maynard, for the non-lucrative, is it 3 or 6 months bank statement? Bob, it depends on each consulate. Some consulates with 3 it's enough. Our advice would be to have at least 6 months, this amount. Natic, vivo en Murcia y cumplí mis 3 años en ese septiembre. En mis esos 3 años, solo el tercer año fui ilegal. Es que los 2 años fue ilegal. ¿Todavía puedo hacer arraigo? Sí, podría solicitar arraigo. Natic, la consulta cuesta 60 euros y tendrías una consulta con uno de los abogados del despacho. Entonces, si nos envías para pagar, te agendaríamos una cita. Consulta número 7. I have a family reunification permit, but I work as a marine chief engine the company. I don't top loss my residency either anyway. Well, you can be a maximum of 182 days out of the country every natural year from 1st of January to 31st of December in order to be able to renew it. Question number 7, Laura Inés. I'm a British citizen, chartered accountant. What is the time? Can I get a work permit? Well, my advice would be to come with a non-lucrative showing 26,000 and then after 1 year to switch into a lucrative permit with a work offer or to set up a company. Sandra Russell, question number 8. Are the extra costs involved, tax and legal wise, on a property for? Well, Sandra, when you buy a property of half a million, 500,000, you need to add 10% of the notary, which is, sorry, 10% of the tax of the state, of the property transfer tax, which is 50,000. You need to add also around 2,000 euros for the notary, 2,000 euros for the lawyer, and 1,000 euros for the register. So it would be 55,000 more or less the expense additionally to the 500. Question number 9. I'm working in Spain as a deputy from India as a highly qualified professional. My wife came from India as a dependent and she's also working here. My business is sponsored by a company and my work permit is linked to it. Now I want to change my job. Please advise. Well, if you want to change your job, you have 30 days to notify this change in order not to lose the permits. Yeah, Natik, in your case for arraigo, perhaps a lawyer from Murcia area would be better. And well, that's all. That's all for today. Don't forget to send us an email with your questions, to call us in the office, to visit our websites, WhatsApp, Skype, book a consultation. We are ready to help you in all this matter. Thanks for your attendance. I hope it was useful, the webinar. And we will keep in touch for the next webinar next week. And thank you for everything.